years to come, and I still remember it vividly. In short, there is red state behavior and blue state behavior in the theater, just as there is in Washington. Bumptious Republicans could have learned a lot about generosity, humanity, and fraternity from watching David work with the actors he loved. Chief among the many other works of art that David helped develop, perhaps the most important, was his family. For David's achievements were not only artistic, but profoundly domestic. I'm speaking first of his beloved wife, Branya, who we all love, herself a powerful actor, of whom I still have vivid memories as the nurse in my production of Strindberg's The Father, putting a straitjacket on the unwitting Christopher Lloyd. And I'm also speaking of his gifted, loyal, and devoted son, Louis, so incredibly caring to his father during the last months of his life. I had occasion recently to see Louis play the part of Jamie Tyrone in A Long Day's Journey Into Night at the New Rep, which also had Karen McDonald giving that splendid performance as Mary Tyrone. And I thought, what a leap for an actor who so loved his father to play a character so alienated from his own. And I also thought, what a joy it must have been for David to have created such a sweet and talented legacy. Louis, would you come up and accept your dad's posthumous award? You'll have to wait a little while for your own.
Allow that organic work to just bloom and take shape. Kate Snodgrass is going to read a few words just from Teresa Rebeck, who couldn't make it tonight. So, Kate, come on.
I'm an understudy. I hope you don't mind. I don't think David minds either. This is from my friend and David's playwright, Teresa Rebeck. David was my teacher, and I never had a better one. My husband, Jess, who also was one of David's students, used to say to me, "That guy has forgotten more about theater than you and I will ever know." His buoyant wit and great capacity for joy was always in service to the art that he loved, as well as to all his accolades, us. But his innate kindness and humor always only underlined the shrewdness of his vision. His profound understanding of character had Chekhovian subtlety and Dickensian bravado, and that didn't stop at the edge of the stage. When they told me David's heart had failed, I thought, oh no, that's not possible. That's really not possible. If David's heart fails, we're all lost.
Our job